sewers. This is the Turtle Power Podcast.
This is your audio source for all the news, reviews, and insight into the world of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Now join your hosts, Brian, Alex, and Darby.
Bossa Nova!
What?
Yeah? Bossa Nova?
Chevy Nova?
Oh.
Excellent!
Yeah.
Now it's time for the Turtle Power Podcast.
One of my favorite things that Ryan does is right as the intro's playing. Darby, you're hosting, right?
Okay, sure, why not? I guess I'll just jump right in. And thanks for that, Ryan. Not only did you send show notes, but you just drop it on me right during the intro. That's fine, I'm good. I've got Donatello power, so I'm ready to go.
Oh no!
Oh yeah, I went in right away. It's to me biggest story since we last did an episode. We'll get into it. We've got actually a lot to get into today. We finally hit the 1,000 Twitter follower mark. I think that's pretty cool. I don't know if it's a big deal for you guys. I mean, I like it. We've got Ninja Turtles at ballpark games. We've got Ninja Turtle race cars. We have a Ninja Turtle parody of sorts that we'll get into later. We have, pre-order bonuses for the video games. We have absurdly expensive action figures, models, action figure. I don't know what you want to call them, statuettes. We have far more to get into, so we're going to jump right into it. Guys, are you there? Ryan?
Are you here? Yep, Ryan and Alex. Alex, hi. How are you?
Hey. Ryan and Alex are actually recording this while they drink a milkshake, one with two straws. I hope you guys are.
We already did that. And we enjoyed some hot beef with each other as well.
Some big beef.
Yes, big beef.
Gotta keep it kosher. Gotta keep it kosher.
So for anybody who's a Chicagoland, frequenter or resident of the greater Chicagoland area, right?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Why not?
So then you know about Portillo's. Portillo's is a very famous Chicagoland.
Are they paying us? Then shut up.
I feel like I got a deal out of that lunch. I could have paid a lot more.
Hey, I don't know if you know this.
I would have paid a lot more.
Kind of a big deal.
Eight bucks for like 2 pounds of beef.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's Italian beef sandwiches. If you know anything about Chicago, you know about Italian beef sandwiches. Anyway, the first Portillo's in Florida just opened up miles away from Alex's in-law's house here. So we are checking out the palatial. Oh, that's so terrible. We're checking out the palatial.
You asexual monster.
Yes. craft room. We're here in the official West Tampa craft room annex of the Turtle Power Podcast.
Oh my God. Is that what Alex calls that room where he watches all of his cat videos?
No. This is the jerk tank.
Speaking of jerk tank, we're going to get into that later too.
Oh man. So this is fun. We're here together.
Yeah.
We're very first time we've had any of us together in the same room during a show. Darby, we wish you were here. We wish you still lived in Florida.
No, not really.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm glad.
Neither do you. I'm happy. You don't want to be here anymore.
I think you guys should just come out here and just enjoy the awesomeness that is Colorado. I'm just saying.
You've enjoyed the awesomeness that is Colorado before.
Oh, yeah, you have no idea.
Yeah.
Anyway, should we get into this, or are we going to sit around and just talk with Michelangelo the entire time? What are we doing?
We can get the show started properly here. Let's jump right into it.
We finally, after waiting months and months of just watching this Twitter counter slowly work its way up. We hit 1,000 Twitter followers, guys.
Yay!
I mean, I was pretty happy with that. I was the one who tweeted it out. You could tell from my trademark hashtag. And I'm kind of disappointed. Ryan, I stole the thunder from Ryan because he was actually wanting to be the one that tweets it out. Sorry, I stole your thunder there, bud.
No, that's fine. But you are confusing the International Bossa Nova Society.
It's a thing. Have you seen this? Have you started seeing? You guys got mad at me. You're like, Darby, look what you started, because some of our fans are actually starting to use the Bossa Nova tweet.
No. You didn't see the Twitter user who did that. That is actually the like International Bossa Nova Society. Like that's a real
there
thing.
There you go. I'm bringing it back, man. I'm kind of my head's getting bigger and bigger. Here we go.
No, that's not how it works. This is like the music Bossa Nova. Like,
yeah. Oh, I'm well aware. but there's a reality that you live in, and there's a reality that I live in, and I enjoy mine far more than yours. Mm.
Was Adam Savage's thing? I substitute your reality for my own.
I reject your reality.
I reject your. Yeah, there it is. There it is. There it is. Yeah. So, yeah. So, thanks to all of our listeners, all of our followers. We really appreciate it. This is pretty cool that, I mean, we certainly haven't set up any sort of community, but I'd say that, we are proud to be part of the greater Turtles, fandom.
Sure.
So,
why not?
Yep.
Oh, exactly. Sounds we're good. Not building a community. We're just a part of a bigger one, and we just bring the news to you guys, and you interpret it how you will, and we interpret it how we will, and life is good for all of us.
I like it. So, Alex, you actually talked about this next story. You brought it up to our attention, I believe.
What story?
Yeah, that one.
I don't remember that. But
you definitely brought this up. I'm pretty sure you tweeted this
Dude,
out.
This happened forever ago.
It did. We won't go into it long, but it made a lot of news.
Though. Hey, there were Yankees fans, and they were dressed up as Ninja Turtles. Next,
they were dressed up as the correct Ninja Turtles. Yeah.
Well,
I don't see any Leo Rafa. I don't see any Rafalis here.
No, because they're not gay enough to be Yankee fans.
I do see Michelangelo and Dongatello, though.
Yeah.
Stop with the Dongatello.
I'm going to see if I can... Huh? What's wrong with Dongatello?
Stop with the Dongatello.
All right, so basically what this was, if you watched John Oliver last week tonight, he put out a thing where... a story about how the Yankees... how they charge like stupid, ridiculous prices.
The Yankees.
And so he basically, to try to give a big middle finger to the Yankees organization, he gave away two tickets to whoever could dress up the silliest. And the two that won were dressed up in full Ninja Turtle costumes.
So is this more of an insult?
Well, I think it's appropriate. It's New York.
Yeah. It's sticking it to the man, really.
It is.
You don't want us common folk to sit up front, so we're just going to do what we want to do.
Well, I think maybe it was maybe not the silliest. It was maybe to have the biggest impact and to have two dudes dressed up in turtle costumes sitting right behind home plate. And that was the kicker because they were on the screen
for
the entire game.
Oh, ESPN even sent out a story about it and tweeted all the pictures of the fans just sitting there behind home plate on TV.
Yep.
It was great.
Yep. So it was good free publicity.
Hey, the Yankees actually made the news for something positive.
So anyway, speaking of New York, there's a new campaign, I guess, for their tourism department. And it's actually, I think, appropriate. I think this is appropriate.
Is it?
Well, so the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles are now the official ambassador to the tourism department. I guess it's called NYC Go. And it's for their, you know, trying to encourage families to travel to the city. And the Turtles are the new ambassadors. So... they are using a series of comic.
Not Captain America, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Wow, Darby, it sounded like.
It sounded like you were goggling a cop.
Sorry. Anyway,
there it is.
So, I was going to say, not Spider-Man and not Captain America.
Well, that's what I was going to say. These are the most iconic superheroes that live in New York. I'm okay with it.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
I'm okay with it. I'm just surprised they didn't go with, you know, characters that are actually coming out with good movies nowadays,
but
or
notice,
characters that have been around for a lot longer. Sure. I'm actually impressed that they picked the Turtles over guys like Spider-Man and Cap.
Well, and notice, too, that these are the the Nick Turtle, the comic book version of the Nick Turtles. That's the Adventures.
Adventures.
Yeah, the Adventures series. So, yeah, because the ads are basically a series of comic book strips, and one for the different boroughs. They got the Bronx and Manhattan and Brooklyn and Queens and Staten Island. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool that, you know, again, some more for free publicity for the franchise. So yeah. Down for it. As always, you can check the show notes for all the links for everything that we're talking about here. And I suggest checking these out to...
Oh, I suggest checking out especially one link in particular. Do it while you're at work. You'll love it. Nothing bad will happen at all for doing it.
Yeah.
I can't wait to get to that story.
Okay.
It's NSFW.
Yeah. This is not NSFW. This next story. So this is from The Guardian. And this was... It's kind of a weird... This is... Kind of a weird story, but basically it was a short interview with Kevin Eastman and David Wise. Of course, David Wise from the 87 animated series, the head writer there. And this was a story called How We Made Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And so not a whole lot to take out of it, except for one line, which I think was very interesting. And that is a line from Kevin Eastman discussing Peter Laird. And this specific quote was, "We've talked about getting together to write another turtle story, but I think he's happy enjoying his free time and his family." So that just the concept, this is something I've totally like said, this is never going to happen again. The concept that we could maybe get a Kevin Eastman, Peter Laird, even just a one issue.
It's not going to happen.
That's so like tantalizing.
It's not gonna happen.
Oh yeah, it sounds freaking fantastic. Yeah,
here we go. we just had to flip our hats around because we're knocking into the mic.
Oh, isn't that cute? You guys are cute.
But yeah, no, I think you're right. I doubt this is gonna happen. But just the fact that it could.
There's a lot of things that could fucking happen.
Okay. Yes.
Oh yeah, totally. There's a lot of things that could happen. You know, I could show up in Florida and do a show with you guys, but I don't ever see that happening.
True. Very true. All right. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with everybody. Who wants to talk about this next one?
Fuck this.
Which one? Yeah, right? Wait, which one? The Danica Patrick story?
That's right.
Yeah, the Danica Patrick story.
Danica Patrick to drive Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle car at Chicagoland for the isn't it for the race, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 400 at Chicagoland Speedway?
Yes.
Yeah. September 18, 2016.
Yep.
They changed the name of the race to the Nickelodeon Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 400, which I'm totally okay with. I'm fine. And then they got Danica Patrick, which, I mean, sure, she's very popular, so that should get a lot of exposure. But don't you want, like, somebody to drive the car that's actually going to be in the entire race?
Thank you. That's exactly what I said.
Because I'm already predicting something. I don't know if you guys tell me, Alex, am I wrong in thinking that?
No, not at all. I don't even like NASCAR, but I know she sucks.
So here's
much better at IndyCar than she was than she is NASCAR.
Right?
Driving.
She actually almost won once.
Well, here's my question: why Chicago?
Why not?
Turtles have no.
There's nothing in New York. Is there?
I don't know, is there?
There's no Speedway in New York. I don't think.
Go ahead and Google that while you guys talk.
A bra? I can't wear this, maybe. I can't wear this, probably. I don't know. That was kind of striking to me. But we do have a one of our listeners is in Chicago. Yeah. Brad, talking to you. So
he listens?
Yeah.
Hi, Brad.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Hey, Brad.
Hey, Brad.
Good to listen to a show that I don't even listen to.
So he's going to... we're in talks to maybe see if we can get him there. So, because I'd love to go to Chicago.
Here's my problem. You want to even know what my problem is?
What?
Those damn business slacks. the hell is she wearing?
Yeah, they got a crease that runs all the way down and everything on both legs.
It's kind of embarrassing. Like, she's supposed to be the eye candy of NASCAR, and she's showing
up
in
that.
That
was like 10 years ago. Now she actually has to get by on her skill, so who knows how much longer she'll be around.
It's a Nickelodeon vehicle. It's a Nickelodeon.
Here's my question. Why is she wearing, like, a heavy jacket? It's not that cold.
It's cold. It's in Chicago.
No, look, they're wearing jackets. Look at the background.
Chicago's not that cold. Not this time of year.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? Because I have friends that live in Chicago that would probably tell you otherwise. Like 2 weeks ago.
There was snow up there
recently,
yeah.
Damn global warming, I tell you.
And Ryan, how long has it been since we've done an episode? Guess what? It was probably snowing back in February too. When the last time we did an episode,
we didn't. It wasn't February.
It was March.
It was March.
It was
very
March,
very
okay.
End of March. This was on April 26th.
And it was snowing in March. What do you want from me?
This is April 26th. This just happened.
Right. It was just snowing. Date
the there. Show.
Yeah.
Just saying. It was cold. It was cold.
It was cold.
That's the point of this story.
It was cold.
It was cold.
That is the whole point of this story. It was cold in Chicago.
Yeah, at
one point.
Point of the story. So anyway, Ninja Turtles 400, Chicago. When is it? September 18th?
September 18th. Yeah, if any of our listeners plan on going, chicagolandspeedway.com. Let us know, and maybe you can go meet Brad.
Hashtag TMNT 400.
That is
right underneath it. Hashtag Bossa Nova. It's great.
Well, that's true. There's a photo of the turtles with like some weird goggles
with,
on.
With Donnie goggles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they're all red, white, and blue. Like the front of them are red, white,
America.
And blue. And then they have like, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what's going on there.
Yeah. Chicagoland Speedway. Have fun. Watch it. If you're down, if you're in the NASCAR, I'm sure you'll enjoy it.
It's part of the Sprint Cup.
Yeah. Yes. That's the big one.
That's the big one,
Ryan.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. That's the majors.
Nationwide is on your side.
Yeah.
So.
Nobody cares about
it. Okay.
No, that's the minors. Those are the minors. Yeah, yeah. Anyway, moving on. Happy to announce, what's this? At Nick Animation. Happy to announce the Nick Animation podcast.
Yeah, so this is an official Nickelodeon podcast, Nickelodeon Animation podcast that has just started. We've got a link to the announcement, the little preview, and then episode one just came out. It features the crew behind Avatar. Actually, I listened to it. It's very good. So, and they've already recorded an episode with Kevin, so that'll be coming up here soon. So, just
how long have
they
been around, and they already got an interview with Kevin?
Well, they're the
it took us like
it's
two
the
years.
Official Nickelodeon. podcast, so they have access to everybody. So
yes,
so
they have
he practically
much more
has
pool
to.
Than we do.
Yeah, he's. I think he's under contract to to appear. So
fair enough. Fair
yeah.
enough.
Next article is May 5th, the real TMNT day. So I wanted to bring this up because we just had this whole kerfuffle, right? With like, wait, we have another official TMNT day, which was not really an official TMNT day.
Right.
That was the official Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3. Turtles or Back in Time. What was the subtitle for Turtles 3, the movie? Was
it Turtles? It was just Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3.
Yeah, I don't think there was anything.
I don't think
special.
It was a subtitle.
I don't think it said Back in Time or anything.
I'll be gonna look this up. You talk. So anyway,
I have nothing to talk about.
Exactly.
So this is
May 5th, and this is Cinco de Mayo, and you have nothing to talk about.
Okay, so well, no, he did. Yeah. Jerk.
I'm Cuban, you son of a bitch.
So we can talk about Cuba. We can talk about do you want
to
go? Do you want to go now?
I would love to go to Cuba.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go see the family.
Hey, check it out. I'm on IMDb right now. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3.
Yes. What does it say?
That's it.
That is not it.
It also has a 4.8 out of 10.
Really?
I believe it.
That's pretty high.
Oh yeah. I know. I'm actually. I believe it, but I'm also kind of surprised.
Hang on.
Yeah, we're
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles
3. Son of a bitch. Yeah, it is just
3. There you go. Oh, Ryan, were Alex and I right?
The turtles. The turtles are back in time, but that's the catchphrase.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, turtles. That's not. There's no title.
Wow.
Yeah, this guy.
Well,
anyway, May 5th. So, is it the official? See, because I think it should be May 29th. I think May 29th should
be
the official.
No, May 29th is definitely not. That's your
May 29th
your birthday.
Is definitely should be the official Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Day.
No. The reason it's May 5th.
Kevin Eastman's birthday is on the 30th, right. And the Ninja Turtles were born at the end of May in 1984. So May 29th, it's a good day. 29 is a good number. I feel like that should be the official Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Day.
Definitely not.
I think so.
So the reason it's May 5th is because the Portsmouth, New Hampshire Minicon from May 5th, 1984, which was located in a Howard Johnson Motor Lodge. That is where Eastman and Laird first unleashed Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number one onto an unsuspecting world.
Nice. So, special guests Steve and Darla Warren, whoever they were.
Yes. Yes, that happened. So,
did.
So I think that is more credible than what the city of Los Angeles deemed was the official Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3 day. So
what day was that?
That was what was that, like March 20 something bullshit day, whatever.
May 29th should just be the official. I'm calling it right now. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Day, May 29th. Everyone celebrate on May 29th because it will be a great day for everybody.
It will not be a great day for everybody. It'll be a great day for you.
I think it will.
So
you know, it's the annual tradition of Ryan forgetting my birthday. Essentially, is what it is.
You forgot his birthday?
I didn't forget his birthday.
It's
on the podcast.
I actually remember Darby's birthday. Your birthday.
After that, where he was like, yeah, May was great. You know, my wife had a birthday and everything. And Alex was like, it was Darby's birthday, too. And I was like, thanks, Alex. Nothing. I'm glad you pointed that out.
Yeah.
We're watching Turtles 3, by the way.
Not the guy that I've been friends with since Daycare Center. That's fine.
Yeah, pretty.
Netflix.
Yeah.
Nice. There was some good cinematography in this film.
No, they didn't.
We're watching Turtles 3 on Netflix. Yeah, Turtles 3 is on Netflix right now, by the way.
For those of you brave enough to watch it.
Oh, come on now. It's not the worst film ever.
It's one of them.
It's not the worst. Come on, they got Yoshi in it.
I mean, if you were Yoshi's to fantastic. Rank all of the Ninja Turtle movies in terms of greatness to craptitude,
hey,
the bottom of that list is Turtles 3.
Tarzan Boy. Hello, Tarzan Boy. You love Tarzan. Darby, you
fucking love Tarzan Boy. It's on my Ninja Turtles mix. I love Tarzan Boy.
Yes.
Doesn't mean I love the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
The only reason Tarzan Boy exists is because of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
In fact, I think the only time I ever laughed watching Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3 was watching a bunch of middle-aged Japanese men dance to that song on the dance floor towards the end of the movie.
You know, I've realized it's not a terrible movie so long as you fast forward through about
the opening
8/10 of it.
Look at this.
Like, wait till they go back in time and then go from there.
Ninjas.
Oh, here we go.
Look at
here
this. Ninjas. 1603 in Japan.
Yeah. Feudal Japan.
Feudal. All right. So next story. Do you have plans to go to New York City anytime soon? Because if you do, we've got a deal for you.
Can I stop you for a second?
Yes, you can.
Tell you how stupid that is.
Alex, feel free to punch him in the face.
That was the point.
You're right here. Tell me that's the point.
That is the point.
That was stupid.
That was the whole point. It was supposed to sound stupid. So, there is an official turtle lair now available for rent at
some pedophile's house.
No, look at this. That's legit.
I know, right? No. This looks like the lair of a guy who like just brings little kids off the street. Like, oh, you want to see my turtle lair? Yeah, come into my turtle lair.
Okay, so now you're gonna feel bad, right? You know why? Because this is official, and all the proceeds go to charity.
Still don't feel bad.
What charity? Tell me the charity.
I don't know the charity.
Well, then, okay.
Do they even list
I donate a lot to charity too. I'm a charity case. I'll do it.
Yes. Okay. It is donate through in their name Pacers National Bullying Prevention Center. There you go. Yeah. Yeah. Now you feel bad. Now you feel bad
because
Darby just loves bullies. So he's like, no, whatever.
I just love bullies. You know.
You do.
Yeah. I'm such a bully. In my 5'8 diminutive stature, yes,
hey,
I'm such a bully.
It is rated.
Yeah.
Okay, so you can check it out, Airbnb.com, and we got a link in the show notes. It's decked out in Turtles gear. The lair area is actually probably the most decked out. It's got some bedrooms, some normal bedrooms. It's not as crazy as I was hoping it would be, but it's.
$10 a night, though. That's like unheard of in New York.
And it does have a one night minimum stay.
That's cheap anywhere.
Yeah.
I mean, especially in New York.
That is cheap anywhere.
Especially in New York.
And, I mean, most places, if you're staying for $10 a night, no.
does have all the essentials though, because it has it comes with shampoo. I don't know if you saw that. Totally comes with shampoo.
Oh, it's good. Like the second amenity shampoo? Listed.
I hope so.
What's up? It's not wheelchair accessible, bottles? Apparently.
And it is 3 bedrooms.
Is it so. No tears?
Oh, that's great. Oh, man.
It's suitable for events. Whatever events you want to throw in there, go for it.
Hey, yo. All right, so let's move on to that, and let's move on
yes,
to
let's move on.
Yeah, okay, we're gonna play. Let's play the trailer. You want to play the trailer audio? I think we should.
Dude, it's like a 2 minute trailer though. I don't know if I want to play 2 minutes of audio. That's I mean,
we're playing the trailer.
Some things are
so. We're playing the trailer.
All right, play the trailer. Anyway, like, we should warn doing. People that this is
it
not safe for work
many moons
before
ago,
they listen to it.
18 years worth below the city. There were 4 regular turtles. But then a horny dude that worked at the nuclear power plant, his radioactive sperm fell into the sewer and onto the turtles. Over time, the turtles grew, especially in the lower shell area.
By the way, they're saying 10-inch Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Already better than Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3.
Pizza guy porn.
Have you heard about the secret gang of ninjas committing crimes across the city? Of course you haven't heard. They're ninjas. They're really quiet.
Also, her name is April O'Neil.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, April O'Neil's a great adult actress.
Pepperoni? I've already got a pepperoni. It's long and green, and it's in my pants.
I am a furry.
Oh, good morning, Michael
Angelo. Trump.
You're about to taste our turtle wax.
Did you like my show?
April!
Liked it, friended it, followed it, got tired of it posting like if you agree memes, unfollowed it, unfriended it, blocked it.
Rocksteady and Bebop decided to stay home because they were too...
Donatello.
Horny.
We're gonna show you the secret of the ooze.
The secret of the spoons!
Nice day.
Rock out with my cock out, dude.
Prepare to get cut. You've already been cut? Down there?
By our Teenage Mutant Ninja Rabbi.
Ninjutsu Kaki!
They're finding the spreader.
Don't step in the poop.
Come a bunga, dude.
Why don't you guys just fuck already and get it over with?
I'm in.
We're coming out of our shells.
It's like 50 Shades of Green.
Balls in play.
Baby batter up.
So good.
I love it. Casey Bones. I love it.
So... The fact that they got in the coming out of our shells mm-hmm. reference,
yeah.
I mean, that's actually fairly legit. They like somebody.
I've always said that coming out of their shells was a legit turtle thing. I don't know why everyone rags on it.
No, what I'm saying
that
is
a legit turtle event that happened.
Yes, it is, of course. But what I'm
and
saying is
great.
That whoever, you know.
They referenced it.
Yeah, the fact that they actually referenced it, that's. They did their homework. Either they did their homework or somebody's a. A big fan.
wait. You mean there are Ninja Turtle fans that also watch porn? No. No.
I didn't say watch.
No. I refuse to believe it.
I didn't say watch.
I watched it.
You act like them doing their homework, quote unquote, is a lot of work. No, they're probably already Ninja Turtle fans because they already came up with this porn parody, which, by the way,
I watched
the whole thing.
Of course you did.
I watched the whole thing. I'm not even ashamed to admit it. I know another host on this show watched the entire thing.
Yep.
You're both married, so whoever wants to call yourselves out on it, go for it. But
no, I mean, I'll say it loud.
I'll say it right now. I was kind of disappointed with it.
Yeah, absolutely.
I was a little disappointed.
I'll tell you one thing. April especially loved Leo at the very end during the circle jerk. And if you notice, she only took his or her hands off once. So I just want to throw that out there. She played around with everybody else, but she held on to Leo strong. So.
Oh, my God. This is
before. Yeah, that was after Casey Bones, showed up. Yeah. That was hilarious. But guys, Alex, mostly I'm asking you because I know Ryan is asexual, so whatever. Here, Alex, I have a question for you. Were you a little upset or a little disappointed that there wasn't any interspecial scenes in this parody?
Considering the way their dongs looked,
Come on. You know you want to see like the whole. Oh, come on.
I was expecting something with the spreader, though. I was expecting something with the spreader, maybe with Splinter. But
they had dildos attached to their weapons and they never used them. And it's like, okay, all right.
It was so terrible, though. It was terrible.
Oh, it was great. Oh, yeah. I mean, it was terrible, but it was funny.
So it's one of those where it's so bad, it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. It's only one big scene.
Okay.
Yeah. It's like
how long is it?
12 minutes long.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's enough to rub a couple up.
Couple.
Yeah, a few.
So bad.
Depends on your mood.
One thing that all men can agree upon. All right.
We watch it for the no. You know what? You know what's the thing that men can agree on? We watch it because it's funny, not because we're into it at all.
Yes. Yes.
That's what.
That's
all men
exactly
can
why Alex watched it. And with that, let's head into video game news.
So, is it sad that a low-budget porn parody has, Their TMNT costumes look better than the TMNT 3.
Well, that was a long time ago.
I don't care if it's a long time ago.
It was a long time ago. They get better stuff now. You know, stuff.
No.
This stuff.
Their budget was $12.
And that all went to April O'Neil, really.
I mean, right.
That she was the only one who probably got paid for that scene.
All right, so May 24th, right around the corner. And why is May 24th a big deal? Not because it's Darby's birthday.
Because the video game comes out. Mutants in Manhattan comes out.
Yes, Mutants in Manhattan comes out. And have you pre-ordered? We're all getting it. We're all getting the game.
Yeah, we're all getting it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So on PS4.
Yep.
So if you want to join us.
What, you want me to play an Xbox?
He's good. He's good, folks. Yeah, so there's two ways you can pre-order. You can pre-order...
Three ways, but, you know, whatever. What do I know?
There's three?
Oh, yeah. There's GameStop, where if you pre-order there, you get special rock and roll costumes for the Turtles. Yes. There's also... You can unlock samurai outfits. And there was a third one, I thought. I thought there was a third one.
So the way to unlock the rock and roll costumes, like you said, is GameStop. If you want the samurai costumes, then you have to pre-order it digitally, and that's
which I think I'll do.
That's the same for Xbox and PlayStation and Steam. So if you get it from any of those that's the one you're gonna get. You're gonna get the samurai costumes, which I like them better. What do you think?
I don't care. I'm pre-ordering through Amazon because I get $10 off. So
So you're just giving a giant middle finger to the costumes.
Yeah, I don't care about the costumes.
Okay.
It's not going to...
Oh, right.
I'm a little confused with the rocker costumes, because I don't understand how Donatello could have hair coming out of his head.
It's a wig, I believe.
Is it?
I think so.
What is that?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
So, maybe that's ooze left over from the... Ghostbusters.
That landed on the turtles and turned them into horny creatures.
Ooze, remember?
No, what?
There's the pink ooze from Ghostbusters.
Don't do Ghostbusters.
I'm pretty sure that's what that was.
From Ghostbusters 2?
2, yeah.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, the one that makes everybody...
it's the same subway.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. I think I just figured it out.
Huh.
There you go. All right. So you mentioned Amazon. Explain more why you're doing Amazon. Why you get $10 off?
If you have a Prime membership, you get $10 off. So $10 off of your order. Which is totally worth it to me, because these costumes are probably going to be eventually released via
DLC.
I would assume so.
I mean, you'll have to pay for them at that point, but it's probably going to be $4.99 per costume pack.
Probably.
Yeah. So
I think it's a safe.
The question I have is, when we all play online together, and say I got the rock and roll costumes and Ryan got the samurai costumes, would my turtle show up with?
I assume so. Yeah. Yeah. We can see what you're wearing, but we can't wear it ourselves.
Gotcha.
Hopefully.
Tiger Claw 305 on Twitter. Of course, always a big assistant to the show. He tweeted us
the biggest one we have.
Yeah, definitely. He sent us a photo that says, looks like the rock and roll costumes are based on the original figures. You remember this figure line?
Oh, yeah. I love that figure line.
Because Donnie's got the mohawk.
The mohawk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got
and Raph has those toy zebra pants.
The Zubas.
Look at those zebra pants. Look at those Zubas. Zebra pants.
Well,
Raphael. I mean, I guess it's better than the black S&M outfit that Ryan loves more than anything in the world.
So bad. Donnie is basically the same. Mikey is basically the same. Leo is basically the same. Raph's a little different because he's not wearing the zebra pants in the game. He's just wearing jeans.
Unfortunate.
It is unfortunate. It's unfortunate. Yeah, actually, Raph's...
Well, he's also...
Raph's is basically completely different because he's got, like, spike shoulders and everything like that. This is a 80s rocker, like, hair metal.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, you know
Mikey's
I mean?
Completely... Oh, no, Mikey's not different. Yeah, changed the Flav Clock to a record.
Yeah.
That's punk rock. That's punk.
That's punk. Donnie's punk. Mikey is rap. Leo is rock. And Raph is... Well, it used to be...
Oh, he's hairband.
Hairband,
he's hairband all the way.
Yeah. But the new Raph is basically metal, I would say.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of like... He looks like Glenn Danzig.
Ah.
Yeah.
There you go.
Reference out of nowhere.
Why did you...
He's trying to get the Misfits together for a reunion tour. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And now... Let's talk about when the game actually releases. So I'm actually going to be, unfortunately, out of the country when this game releases.
Ryan's a jet setter. He's like, guys, I'd love to play with you guys, but I'm going to Denmark, and then I'm going to another country, and then I'm going to another country after that.
Will you be
and then maybe
taking
I'll
the
be
jumbo?
Back in America.
Will you be taking the jumbo jet?
You'll be taking the turtle blimp?
Oh, I would love to take the turtle blimp.
It'd take you forever to get there.
It would. That is true. It already takes forever to get there. See, that's the thing where you're wrong, Doug, because I would absolutely rather stay here and play that game than have to go to Denmark for 2 weeks. So.
And drive an Audi.
Ryan, I have a question for you.
What's that?
This is a very valid question, I feel. The hotel are you staying at, will there be Wi-Fi?
Yes. Yes.
So then you can't just bring your PS4 with you
and
then play in the hotel room or something while we do this thing that we want to do that we've been planning to do forever.
Can you get through?
Well, I don't know. Probably not as a carry-on, but I'd want to do it as a carry-on. I wouldn't want to.
You can do it as a carry-on. It's a PlayStation 4. Like they're not. Are they really going to confiscate a PlayStation 4?
No, they're not going to confiscate it. But
certain countries they will.
Well, not Denmark. Denmark's
No, Denmark's cool.
Yeah. Denmark, yeah. So
I don't know.
Ryan,
I don't know if I have a carry-on that
could with you.
Fit it.
Really? You can't fit it. You are a large man, Ryan. I guarantee
you
took out like one pair of pants, you could fit your PlayStation 4.
Yeah,
in there.
No, that's true. I've got room for it.
Exactly. So why don't you just take your
PlayStation
4? He
just called me a fat
son
of a bitch. I think that's what he just called me.
I think he called you a fat son of a bitch.
Yeah, I think he did. Okay.
No,
I'm pretty sure it's what he said.
I am a tiny person. I'm not James Arnold Taylor tiny. But why can't you?
Okay, well,
why can't you stay up till like 4 in the morning in Denmark time so we can play?
See, and there's your other problem is that there's a 6-hour time difference. So for playing at night with you guys would be basically in the early morning in Denmark.
And you'll be at work.
And I'll be at work.
Right.
Yeah.
So.
You know what? I'm going to figure this out. I'll come up with an idea and a stratagem.
Okay.
It's going to happen.
All right.
I'm going to try to make this happen. I'll try to come up with an idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But that's going to do it for video game news, right?
That is going to do it for video game news. Check the Twitter. Check the Facebook. We'll try to post whenever we do get on to play for you guys. If definitely you guys are going to play right away. So, and then whenever I get on to play. So, you know, when you're getting on, just shoot out a text saying jumping on to play some games.
Yeah, and we're going to do a Let's Play, right? We're still planning on doing that.
Yes. So... We'll probably wait until I get back, I guess, for that.
Yeah.
Okay, so. So, yeah, we're all freaking stoked for this game, though. It's going to be great. I'm expecting one of the best turtle games ever. Is really what
which isn't really saying that much, well, but
yeah.
Sure. I wish they just, you know what? Okay, look. Mutants of Manhattan. Look. I'm stoked for it. I'm really excited. I am so excited for this game, and I can't wait to do the whole like let's play thing with you guys. But a thought just occurred to me where it's like, really would have preferred them to just kind of make Out of the Shadows a longer game.
Yes. Well, that would have been good, but I mean that game had its issues. That game had its technical issues.
So, right. So this they could have just, instead of coming up with a completely new game, why not just fix the awesome one that had its
that
issues?
That game was a waste of money. That's what it was. You want to know what it was? It was a waste of money.
Get the Booyakasha button ready. Here goes Alex.
No, I'm good.
No,
was a waste of money. Okay. I spent, 3 hours on that game? If that?
Not even. I think I beat it in like 2 hours. Yeah, I flew through that game. I was like, wow, issues, I'm already fighting Shredder? Short. What?
Yeah.
Right.
Super short and technical issues. So, but anyway, yes, that'll do it for video game news. So let's go into TV news.
Even
caught up. That's all right. So first thing here is we send a congratulations to the Nick Turtles team. They won a Daytime Emmy Award actually for outstanding sound mixing in animation. So yeah, congratulations.
Good for them.
Yeah, congrats, guys. Yeah.
I would agree. They have some great sound editing on this
yeah.
show.
Yeah.
Sound effects, music, all of it. Next up, this is just really kind of a mention. Rob Paulsen and Kevin Michael Richardson did a short interview over on YouTube.
Paulsen, by the way, look at that goatee on Rob Paulsen. You see that?
Rocking the goatee.
That goatee is one of the finest, best trimmed, nicely groomed goatees on Rob Paulsen, I think I've ever seen. Like, he could play Oliver Queen in a future scenario with that freaking goatee right there. My God, I'm just admiring it. Like, Kevin, you're cool too. Like, you've got a goatee as well. But man, Rob Paulsen's goatee. That's all I can look at right now.
Yeah, we're pulling it up right now. You can just fast forward.
Oh,
yeah,
it's great. It's great. You can, there he is. Right there at the beginning. There he is. Look at that.
This is Comic Book Resources.
CBR Interviews.
Yeah.
Put it on their channel.
Yep. So. There you go. He kind of looks like a, Robin Hood esque, like.
I already said it. If Oliver Queen aged, he could play him with that goatee. Maybe you have to work out a little bit.
I don't know. Does Rob do any British accents or anything?
Yeah, I feel like
you tell me.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I don't feel like he would be Robin Hood, but maybe a mentor.
One of his merry men, perhaps.
Maybe.
I'm digging it. Rob, since Ryan just asked the question, at Yakko Pinky, if anybody wants to tweet out to him, hey, Rob, do you do English accents? Can you do an English accent? I mean, Ryan wants to know.
I do.
So if our fans could just like tweet at Yakko Pinky, that'd be great. And ask him. I'm sure he'll be like, can I do a British accent? No.
Yeah, they'll get him.
I'm kidding. You know he can.
All right, next one is also really kind of just a mention. So Ciro Nielli, he doesn't really do a whole lot of interviews. So this is an interview that he did over – he and Kevin went over to – I think it actually may have went over to – it was Abu Dhabi or
– It was
or was it Dubai? It might have been Dubai.
Well, it was somewhere in
UAE.
UAE.
Yeah.
So
there was a convention over there, and the two of them went over there to represent the Turtles, and so which was crazy for Ciro. Picks a con besides Comic Con and ends up being way out there. So, but so he does a little interview here, talks about his love for the Turtles and where he got started. He's got issue one. He got issue one originally.
Really?
So, yeah. So he's legit, man. I mean, if you didn't know already, this man's legit. So.
Happy birthday, George Lucas.
Hey, all right. Hey. The notorious GL. Yeah. Of course, a big influence on Kevin and Peter.
Yeah.
It, Star Wars influences in early Turtle comics right off the bat. All right, next one. And now you guys said you are not caught up, so I will not spoil anything. This is the
too late. I already read the review.
All right, well, season we had the season finale for the Nick Turtles, and basically tying up this whole Turtles in Space storyline. I thought they did a fantastic job. The IGN review is in the show notes. They agree.
They gave it an amazing rating.
Yeah. Yeah, it was very good. They did. It was very well done. Had some serious emotional connections there at the end. So it's just really cool to see.
It's cool to see two groups of turtles teaming up.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to say it's a spoiler because we have a picture of it in the show notes.
Yeah.
The turtles team up with their past selves to, you know, win the day, I guess. And there's a lot more that goes on, apparently, according to this review, far deeper. But
far
just deep. For the, hey, you know why you want to watch this episode? Future Turtles team up with past Turtles.
Yes.
There you go.
I mean,
go and watch
it. The whole thing where you knew this was coming. You know, this is the only logical way to, you know.
But I have a question, Ron.
What's that?
How far back in time are these past Turtles? Like, did Jason Biggs come back to voice Leo?
I believe no. It's only like 6 months. It's basically to the end of
right before the Earth exploded.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yeah. That was basically the whole. That was the MacGuffin. That was the MacGuffin for this entire season. Was
9.0 on IGN.
Yep.
Dang.
Yep.
Good for them.
Very good.
Yeah.
So highly recommend it. Check it out. And you know, the last episode we talked about how Rob had sent out a tweet saying that they were doing another get together with the old cast and the new cast. So, but then he had to take it down or whatever. So, well, Brandon Allman, who is he's one of the executive producers, I think he's right there with Ciro. He put out on Instagram a photo that's got Cam Clark and Seth Green and Barry and Rob and Greg, and so is the whole. I mean,
hey guys, who's the guy? Who's the one next to Greg Sipes in the picture? The guy in the green.
That is Michelangelo, the original Michelangelo.
Okay, I take it back. He has the greatest goatee ever. Yes. Thank you. No, he does. That is amazing. I'm a fan.
You're a fan?
Oh, yeah. Anyway, continue, Ryan. Sorry.
Yeah, so anyway, it was... so it's out there now, you know. That's Townsend Coleman, by the way. That's out there now, so it's confirmed. Old Turtles are coming back again. So I don't know how they're going to do it this time. Maybe it'll be a similar storyline, or I don't know. But we will have more Classic Turtles, Nick Turtles crossover. And I don't know, when is the new, or no, I'll say new, when's the next season start? I'm not even sure.
Did they even announce that yet?
I don't know. Let me
I'll look it up. I'll look it up. You continue.
I got it right here. All right.
I got it.
That was okay. So that was season four. Season five. I don't see anything for season five. So
exactly. Yeah, I don't know, Ryan. I was like, Ryan, I don't think they announced it yet. No, they totally did. They announced the fifth season.
Yes,
according to the Wikipedia page, they announced the fifth season. But I don't think there's been a release. If we're wrong, feel free. Like, hey, we're not perfect. Like, if we're wrong, feel free to tweet us and everybody else. This is when the fifth season will come out.
Yeah.
Like, this is the release date. Yeah. Let us know.
Yeah, because right now
Ryan doesn't send show notes anymore. He makes me go into his Dropbox to pull them out, and of course, I didn't do that until about 5 minutes before showtime. So, because I didn't know Ryan wasn't sending them out anymore.
They are always there. The idea is that, you know, throughout the month, you occasionally go in and you say, oh, so let's see, what's new? What haven't I seen? Oh, look at that. Okay, this is a collection of all the stuff. It's always
there.
You know
what, Ryan? That totally is a great idea. Probably should have told me about that.
Definitely told you about that.
Nope. Don't remember that.
Just like I totally told you where to get it. All right. Anyway, next up is... Oh, that's where he ducked his head? Yeah.
Yeah.
So terrible. He missed me. That's what he says right there. Yeah. How do I remember that? I can't remember things from high school, but I can remember that. Where Willie? Oh, that's fantastic. All right.
$300.
Yeah. Okay. So let's go. Speaking of which, let's go into collecting news.
From Playmates.
All right. So next up, we got update on the Hero Clicks. yeah. So
stop. Ryan. Ryan.
You hate it when I do that.
No. Everybody hates it. Hey,
you got Greg Sipes in the house, everybody.
All right. So we have a unboxing of the Turtles Hero Clicks. You remember we talked about this, the Hero Clicks. No, I still don't know anything about tabletop gaming.
We don't need to know anything about it. Well, that's how we learn.
It's not even that. Unboxing, it's not my thing. Like, I keep hearing how popular these unboxing channels are.
I think it's something for a younger generation than us. If we're the generation, now they're starting to lump us in with millennials.
Please don't do that. Don't.
No, exactly. We used to be generation Y. There was X, and then there was Y, and then there was millennials.
Yeah.
But now they're lumping Y in with millennials, and I don't agree.
I think we're X. I drank a lot of Pepsi.
No, we're Y. We're technically Y.
No, I mean, but X I drank a lot of the Pepsi.
Right before
so I'm X.
Ryan was born.
It's the choice of a new generation.
Yeah, here's the thing. I even posted this on Facebook. Probably my favorite thing about our generation and why our generation is so great is because growing up, we used to laugh at old people for not knowing technology. And now we laugh at little kids for not knowing what an Atari is.
Yes, that's true. They should
like,
be
we're
mocked.
Not technologically inept. You are, because you don't know about a machine that existed 25 years before you were born.
Hey, it's always important to know about your history.
Hey, did you know that kids born in the year 2000 can drive?
Ugh.
That's scary.
Ugh. Yeah.
I'm not even mad because I feel old. That's just scary because they're a bunch of idiots. All of you.
always, you kids always tweeting on your phones while driving.
Snapchatting dick pics.
My dad actually
comic
goes.
Comicbook.com, YouTube channel, unboxing, Ryan.
My dad goes, I saw you you did the tweet on the Facebook there. I was like, yeah, Dad. Yeah, totally.
Did you ever take any dick pics? Just curious.
Not going I'm so glad and... that this is coming up in a Ninja Turtle podcast.
No, I haven't. Should I?
No, Ryan doesn't need to. He's been married since he was 15 years old. Like, he doesn't need to.
Do you need two phones?
I was 16.
You might need two phones. He needs a wide-angle lens. He needs that panoramic shot.
You guys are funny.
Can I get a panoramic shot of my penis?
Anyway.
Wow. All
right, Mondo updates.
Mondo update. So, for anybody who purchased one of the...
Mondo as in, man, that's a Mondo price. I've been hanging out with Ryan too long. I'm sorry, guys. Sorry.
Yeah, no, the Mondo's not that bad, comparatively speaking.
It's still bad.
Well, Leo is unfortunately delayed by a few months,
I'm okay with it. I don't think people are too torn up about that.
But once they've got his quality control locked down, the other turtles will roll out about a month or so apart after that. So they are a little delayed on those figures. So stand by. And we'll try to keep an eye on the Mondo updates. Let y'all know.
Gotcha.
Dude, I took my head off, right? It's pretty
you
long.
Need to cut your hair, bro. Cut your hair, bro.
I need.
Yeah. No, he's growing a man bun. He's man bun. Remember,
dude. I'm gonna cut his hair today.
I have a top knot, not a man bun.
Are you a samurai? No.
Actually,
then just no, Ryan. Just no. No, you have size. Don't even ask. Like, oh, yeah, I don't know. I've got a.
Hold on. No, we have. Look at this. Ah, there it is, right there, it's right there. That's it, right there. That's it, right there. That is it, right there. That is fantastic. What? We got Turtles 3 going, and there is my that's my hair right there.
I'm gonna send you. I got you.
Wait, what hair? Not Casey Jones' hair.
No.
I got you right now.
He's sending it to you. I'll keep going. I'll keep going. All right, so the next story is Prime One's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles will cost you a radical sum.
Oh, my God. Ryan's hair. Does he really look like that right now?
He could.
I could. I need a tie. I need a hair tie.
Ryan, tweet out a pic or something, man. I need to see this.
I'm on Facebook.
You need to cosplay this.
Hold on. Oh yeah, that won't be racist at all.
You're talking about this and all.
Wait, Ryan's eyes are pretty narrow though, so I guess you'd be.
Please do this.
This is how I normally wear my hair. Keep talking.
Yeah, Mondo.
No, Mondo.
Ryan putting his hair up right now?
Are we on Prime One?
Yes, we're on Prime One.
Hey, Prime One. They look amazing. They're $2,300, $574 a piece. You got the money, buy them. You don't, too bad. Moving on.
$2,300.
Yep.
And they're not even expected to ship until December.
Dude, I feel like, is douchiness contagious? Because I feel like I'm about to turn into a douche. Just watching
With Ryan's hair.
There's nothing wrong with my hair.
Oh my gosh!
I'm Ryan. I tweeted out a million tweets about how I ran a marathon at Disney World, but I actually stopped every 5 minutes to ride a ride.
All right, so he's taking a photo of my hair. I don't have any product in my hair.
I don't have any product.
Normally, because the front here, there's not quite long enough.
I don't want to hear it.
Yeah, Ryan, we don't care. We don't care. If we're not, I don't care about your hair. It's ridiculous. But these Prime One, $2,300. Really?
$2,300.
Yeah. I want to talk about these figures right now because Donnie, Leo, and Mikey look amazing. Raph, what is that face?
That face is from the original movie. He makes it.
Well, I know exactly what it's from, okay. But that doesn't mean it's a good face to put on his action figure that I'm going to pay $574 for.
I feel like that is the right face.
Nah.
That speaks Raph to me. What do you think, Ryan? Because, I mean, you're the Raph guy.
Yeah, you're
well,
the Raph
they
guy.
Come with multiple... Don't they come with multiple heads? No, they don't.
No. You got that lucky.
Well, what, you pick for $2,300, you're going to get more heads?
I thought... there's so many of these things now that I can't keep track of them all. And these are not... Are they not opposable? Or are there...
I think they're just statues.
Yeah, they're just statues.
Oh, that's very disappointing.
The shading, though. Look at the shading, man. It looks amazing.
The shading. I'd say Mikey is probably the best.
It better be. For $2,300, it better make me breakfast every morning.
As far as the faces go, I think Mikey's probably the best.
Donnie's is cool.
I thought Donnie's was.
I'm a Donnie guy, so I'm biased. I like Donnie's face.
Well, okay, so when we talked about this line before, because at the New York Toy Fair, they released, or they had the Donnie there. And people were taking photos of
Alex.
It. But now we have all the photos of all four. But I don't know, man. It's more power to whoever can afford this. So
I can't believe that. 23. I mean, yeah, sure. Most turtle fans are probably successful and in their 30s, like Ryan, and can afford it. But $2,300, jeez.
Let me finish paying off my debt first.
That's a cool shirt.
Nah. Sorry, you're going to Denmark for 2 weeks. No.
I'm not paying for it.
I know you're not. That's what makes it even better.
It's your tax dollars at work.
Exactly.
All right, so let's move on. Next one here is the Lunar Toy Store on Facebook. This is the third-party first Gokin Shredder, which I think we've talked about before.
Yeah.
This is
amazing.
Yeah, this is an update. It says, a small update for all you fans have been waiting for. As much as I want to share the full set of updated photos with you guys, is all I can share. Once I get more solid update, I will post and share it with you guys. So we've got a link to it in the Facebook. You can take the helmet off. Even the under... That looks like...
Steven Seagal?
Yeah, I can see that. Steven Seagal with him. I was going to say Sub-Zero.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That makes more sense.
Yeah. So, looks fantastic. And very opposable. You can see the joints there. And then also, this is the same creator that did the first Gokin Cerebral Krang, which is out.
So good.
And you can actually get this. Let's see. What is this running for? $160.
Yeah.
It's a special price right now. We got the link in the show notes. You can get one. This is that really awesome looking 87 Krang android body that looks like it's in an anime.
What's that looks like how I would want the Krang in the movie to look like.
Right. Well, I mean, it's not that far. It's just, it's not that different.
What's the scale on it?
Do
you know?
Let me see.
Regardless, 160 is a good price for it.
That's not that bad. For this, I mean, it's pretty big.
Whatever.
Sorry, I'm preoccupied with something right now. Continue.
So anyway, yeah. So
these Heracross toys. What?
Okay, yeah. So let's go into that. That's fine. Let's just go into that. So this is a line called Heracross Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. This is interesting because there's so many of these vinyl figures now, but this is like kind of like taking a Funko and then like doing it up. Like,
it's proportioned.
Yeah. So these are six inches tall, with plenty of articulation, which of course, you know, Funkos, you don't really have any.
Right.
But and this is going to have all kinds of accessories, different hand holds, different heads, accessories.
Hey, did you guys see that tweet that just went out on our Twitter account?
I did not. No. Do we have breaking news?
We have. Well, it's a tweet that I just sent out that I was preoccupied with. I tagged Ryan in it. So I feel like you guys should definitely check out that tweet that I just sent out. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you there. These figures, though. I think Alex has seen it.
Yeah, that's my hair. I'm dissing my hair. I worked a long time on this hair.
Anyway, so these Heracross figures, am I the only one that thinks, with the exception of Raph, they all look really angry? Like, too angry? Like,
well, that's why they have their smiley face. That's why they have the smiley face head, too.
Yeah.
See, if you're going to do... Okay, I get it. If you're going to do the mean face, why not... I mean, you tell me. Would you rather have the mean face or would you rather have the no pupil face?
The nope. Oh. But these...
You know,
well, these were
about
the,
to get
the
real,
old...
it's like, all right, no pupils, let's do it.
Yeah, but these are the 87 series,
right.
So...
Right, I wouldn't want no pupils for the 87 series. I don't think it would look right.
But in terms of like a figure in itself, I mean, pupils or no pupils, I prefer none.
I prefer none. Yeah, I agree.
Ooh. So yeah, these are not available yet. These are just a preview.
No price on it either.
Yeah.
All right, I want to hear what Alex has to say about this next story.
Not there yet.
Or is that movie news?
That's movie news.
Oh.
Then
let's jump right into movie news.
Wait, hold on. hold on. We're definitely not going. This next story, this is not movie news. This is, if you're going down the line of the
news?
Show.
Okay.
Yeah. So, this
I just asked you if it was movie news, and you're like, yeah, it's movie news.
There we go.
I didn't know what you were looking at. All right.
Can't wait
yes.
this guy.
Okay, so this is a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Leonardo Katana prop replica. Available from Factory Entertainment.
Alex, I assume you already have this in your man cave already?
No. Because it's $250, and I don't really want to spend $250 on a replica. So, yeah.
Yeah, you can get a real sword for $250.
Yeah.
Easy.
Not a good one.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
You can definitely get a good sword for $250.
I just make
but this
own.
Has a high carbon steel blade.
Oh.
Well, that's good.
Like and it has a certificate of authenticity.
I
and
like
just
the,
like Ryan, it is 41 and a half inches long.
What?
Add to. That's museum cool. quality. I wonder what turtles. Actually qualifies
yeah,
for that.
Too. Yeah, the sheath has a little turtles
on it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, That's kind of neat.
Actually, the I'm pulling up the website.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, it's got them in the handle as well. That's pretty cool. I mean, it looks great. It looks fantastic. But yeah, I'm not. Like even the little hand guard there.
I don't have any room for
it.
Hey
Ryan, actually. Are you gonna buy a $250 replica of Raphael's size?
No,
when they come out,
because I already have size, and they would destroy Raphael's size. That's the truth.
If only you knew how to wield them.
I definitely know how to wield them.
Too bad they wouldn't destroy Leo's sword. Because that was bullshit.
That not only would that happen, it did.
No,
it
that was
definitely
BS.
Did happen.
Yeah, that was BS.
Because that's how torque works.
Ryan's an engineer, so I really can't argue against him for that. I can't argue against that. I just have to take his word for it, and I hate that.
The
I know he's full of crap.
Modulus of elasticity was brought to such a high level that it could not return back.
This is foreplay between him and Jess. This is
no. Foreplay between him and Jess would be like, oh baby, meow like a cat. I love cats. I have 8 of them. Like, yeah, just meow for me. That's their foreplay. He meows. Meow, meow, meow.
So let's talk about this. Museum quality, screen accurate details. certificate of authenticity. That's important.
Are we still on the sword? Can we move on?
I skipped like 8 stories ahead.
All right, let's go into comic book news.
I strike 2 on my way down. Donatello takes out a 3rd with his staff. Already the pudgy ones are starting to panic. Raph loves this stuff. He's not alone.
Why is he narrating? Is he crazy?
Hardcore crazy.
I love these guys!
Nice.
Turtles Forever. Forever in our hearts. All right, so this was actually some pretty big news. There is now going to be basically a Turtles expanded universe, where it's still going to be comics. Basically, it's the whole concept that in the IDW Turtles series, there are so many characters now, so many interesting characters, that they could not fit all of the stories and all of the concepts that they wanted to for all those characters into the main Turtles story arc, right? So now there is going to be what is called the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles universe, and it's going to have basically stories for all the other for all these other characters that that have been created. So I'll go ahead and read the quick synopsis here. Introducing a new era in TMNT, the series will explore characters and storylines that are pivotal to the IDW TMNT universe. When a mysterious new mutant targets Baxter Stockman, it will be up to the TMNT to reluctantly save him. Little does everyone know that a larger trap is being laid by a new arch foe. Plus, a backup story from TMNT co-creator Kevin Eastman and comics legend Bill Sienkiewicz. So,
did you say that correctly?
I think I did. So,
good job.
Yeah.
By the way, that cover art, huge fan of that cover art.
Yeah, this is Freddie Williams.
I love
the
way the turtles look, except for Mikey. Mikey kind of looks like when a girl takes a selfie from a bad angle and her face looks like Michelangelo's right now.
Mikey looks like Majin Buu.
He looks like he's eaten one too many pizzas, actually.
He looks
actually
like
looks
Majin
chunkier
Buu.
Than the other turtles.
Was it Boo? Boo or Majin Buu? Which one is he? Mm.
Which
Boo.
One?
Boo. Boo, right?
Oh, yeah, Majin Buu.
Majin Buu. Yeah.
So characters named by Bobby Kurnow include Casey Jones, Fugitoid, Old Hob, April, Nobody, Harold, and Baxter Stockman. Baxter. Plus, he teased we'll get a couple of brand new villains as well. So
there you go.
Looking forward to this. Looking forward to seeing how they can expand when they're given a little bit more time to veer off the main storyline and see what they can do with
it. It's going to be coming out for what? $5? That's it.
Yeah, it's a little bit bigger.
40 pages.
It's 40 pages. Yep, a little bit bigger. And it's going to be on sale in August. So
nice.
Looking forward to that. Next up, we've got a this is a preview of Deviations.
Wait, real quick. Who did this cover art?
I said his name. It's Freddie Williams the second. Cool. Yep.
All right.
Yep.
Just want to make sure like he got his due, because that cover art, I love it.
This is on the bottom right there. It's got his little insignia. Freddie Williams the second. Next up, yeah, preview of Deviations. If you haven't picked up Deviations yet, it's out right now. So we have a preview of it in the show notes if you want to check out a preview of it. We had a one of our listeners, X_Sunil? S-U-N-I-L?
Yeah.
Says, you guys read TMNT Deviations? Damn, this shit is crazy fucked up awesome! I assume that's how he was typing it. I mean,
you bought it lit.
Did you say lit? Oh man! Well,
I'm referencing a viral video. I just dated the episode. I'm sorry, guys.
Yeah, you did. So I'm gonna be loading up on some of the comics for my trip on Friday. So I'll be adding this to the reading list. So I'm looking forward to it. You haven't read it yet, have you?
No. Can you stop looking at me like that?
It's fun. You're right next to me.
It's
like our faces.
So this is what's going on, Darby.
Darby, our lips are so close to each other right now.
As like, if he's expecting me to do anything. He's getting the behind
the scenes
look.
Alex, you have those dreamer's eyes. You know, it's hard not to get lost in them.
Finally getting the behind the scenes look as far as what I do during our podcast, which is absolutely nothing.
This is true. it's okay. I'm going to be checking this out probably this weekend.
Stop staring at me.
This week. I'm not staring. This time what is this? This is what I keep looking at. I don't know what that is. We're in a craft room.
All I know is you guys are so close to one another that you had to turn your caps around. That's all I know.
We were so close to one another, I had to ingest lavender.
Yeah, you did. Okay. All right, next story is six of the weirdest moments in Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles comics history. So this is pretty fun. So I saw this and I thought this was something we could go over on the show. Some of these we've talked about already.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so let's just go down the list here. Number one, Cuddly the Cowlick.
Cowlick!
Of course. Everybody loves Cuddly the Cowlick.
By the way, Michelangelo, now that's what I call cowabunga. Oh, 80s turtles. Never change.
Yes. This is, I will say, also mention that most of these are from the Archie series. that was definitely full of turtle craziness. So that's number one, Cuddly the Cowlick, of course. The number two one is actually says the original turtles were dark. Yes, they were. They've got some scenes here of Leo just running through Shredder here.
Shredder didn't get the Shredder kill on
that one. What is
Donnie
that?
All the way. What? That was Donnie. Donnie's first Shredder kill was the first Shredder kill.
What does that mean?
It means, oh, shit.
Oh, okay. In 84.
Yeah, that's the first emoticon.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Number three, this entire issue, the Stump Arena presents the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, of course, the Intergalactic Wrestling Federation.
So good.
Ryan's good. Favorite RAF costume.
Yes. Yes. Look at that. That's, I mean, just fantastic. All right.
I don't know why Donnie went red. I think it's weird that Donnie went red for that. I don't get it.
Mm-hmm.
I hate Donnie's outfit in that.
Now, interestingly, he's wearing what Raph wears in the current movie series. See that? He's got
the red headband that goes all the way around, like the do-rag.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Donnie rocked it first.
I think we had this conversation before, actually.
Did we?
Yeah.
Number, what are we on? Four?
Hey, look, it's Hellraiser.
Wing nut and screw loose.
Hey. Crayon glasses.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Oh, Mr. Potato Head. How about that?
Yes, wing nut and screw loose.
R2.
Oh, look at that. Oh, my gosh. Look at that. There is a... Sorry to go back, Darby. There is an R2-D2 definitely in the crowd. And what
I'll
else do you
see? I'll
take
your word for it. I don't scroll up after I've already scrolled down. I'll take
is
your word
for it. Is there
Triceraton? Is there?
Yeah. Right top in the middle? Yep.
Yeah.
Right next to Krang potato.
Krang. No, I think that's the poop emoji with Krang glasses.
Ah, with the Krang glasses.
Poop emoji.
Oh yeah. So next one, yeah, Wingnut and Screwloose. Now, what are they saying bad about Wingnut and Screwloose? Which, of course, they are still wearing the Intergalactic Wrestling Federation suits here. I think I have this issue. Maybe I do. Maybe I don't. And next one, Shredder joins forces with Krang. I do remember this.
Yeah.
I definitely remember this.
What? Yeah. What is this?
That is definitely Krang giving Shredder a close-up view of his anus.
Yeah. Did he just sit on top of Shredder's head and was like, cool, I'm here now. This is where I live.
In this issue, Krang gets the upper hand on Shredder and somehow manages to become Shredder's head, taking over his body. Krang eventually gets his squishy
butt.
Yes, they did. Taken off the Shredder by the Turtles, which results in a very temporary alliance between the Turtles and their nemesis. Dun dun dun. And then, of course,
By the way, this number one, I'm not going to lie, the greatest Raph moment in all of the comics. Like, hands down. Sure. This is the greatest thing Raph ever did in the comics.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think. Of course, that's Raphael just punching Hitler right in the face.
Well,
because why not?
Yelling for the millions.
Yeah. For the millions!
Probably just like not.
That. No? And that's why Ryan's not a voice actor.
He's with a. No, he's with a. Except with a.
No, he's got to do the Batman Bronx? Voice.
Are you doing the scream for the first movie? Is that what you're going for?
Right.
Did you notice how?
With a million.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, that was good.
Did you notice how Spidey? You saw Cap? Did you see Iron Man?
Of course I did.
Darby, you saw it. Did you see it yet?
Did I see the greatest Marvel movie ever made? Yes, I did.
Well, you've seen the trailers though.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's pretty cool that Spidey's got kind of like an accent, like a. Queens, right?
He's a kid.
Yeah.
He's a kid. I love it.
Oh, they did a fantastic job. You'll enjoy it very much. All right. Let's see. What do we got next here? Turtle Flakes sent us a tweet, which I appreciate. This is really cool. It says, here's the IDW timeline for each TMNT story arc up to volume 12. So this is pretty cool. And so I guess IDW created this.
Yeah, you remember the issue one that was released for $1 recently from IDW?
Yes.
I purchased that, and it actually comes with this story arc.
Oh, nice. Oh, awesome. So this is... It's got a nice little rundown of everything, where it goes, all the issues and everything, and even the Ghostbusters crossover.
Yep.
Oh, man. It's actually pretty cool looking at this. You're starting to remember all these different stories.
Where's Batman? Where's Batman?
Batman is in the DC universe, actually. So it does not fall in the IDW timeline.
Oh, so DC... I thought IDW was doing that series. No,
DC has the rights to that.
Huh.
Yep.
Okay, then. Or something new every day.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you brought it up.
I don't listen on this show.
out now, really quick. IDW issue 58 was just released on May 11th. Issue 59 is coming June 22nd. The TMNT Batman crossover issue 6.
Hardcover coming August 17th. Yes. I'm going to get it.
Yeah, hardcover is releasing August 17th. Issue 6 just released also on May 11th. Deviations is out now. We mentioned that earlier. Bebop and Rocksteady Destroy Everything. That's the next miniseries coming out. That's going to be issue 1 coming June 1st. And actually all 5 will be released throughout June.
Nobody has any jokes to make about that. Come on, guys. I'm giving it to you. No, nobody wants. Okay.
I wasn't listening at all.
I read it and I wasn't listening.
Never mind.
IDW Adventures. The Amazing Adventures issue 10 is coming May 25th. And
look, guys, if you really want to be like mean, you're supposed to say Bebop and Rocksteady Destroy Everything, and then in parentheses you put including Donatello. Come on. You guys are soft.
Wow. This guy.
That was so vague.
Including Donatello. That's where I would have gone.
So
if
last was, year.
If Leo would have been the one taking that sledgehammer, I would have been like, yeah, like Leonardo. Come on.
Yeah, clearly you're more there than we are.
You had a vested interest in whether he lives or dies.
Well, we had zero.
We didn't care at all.
No.
Yeah.
Fingers crossed.
I think he deserved it, really.
Yeah.
There you go. There you go. That's the vinegar I'm looking for. Come on, do it.
Issue 11 is coming June 8th of the Amazing Adventures. And then let's see here. The Carmelo Anthony special, the one you guys are really looking forward to, that's coming May 25th of the Amazing Adventures. So, yeah, Mirage Tales of the TMNT
Could
volume.
Get somebody that at least won one ring. I mean, really.
You used that joke last time. Can't use
I know, because it's a serious concern that I have. It's not a joke. Yeah, no, it's okay. A serious, like, I'm not joking. There are so many better players and so many, like, more accomplished players that they could have gone with. But I guess he was the only one available, because the ones winning rings aren't. They're too busy winning rings.
That's a fresh one. That's a good one. All right, yeah, what we're smelling here is Tales of the TMNT Volume 8, which is out now. It collects issues of the Mirage Tales of the TMT Volume 2, issues 22 through 25. Volume 9 is going to be scheduled for August 16th release. I just picked this up and it smells fantastic.
Yeah, the animation
varies
for certain artists.
It varies.
Leaves a lot to be desired.
Look at that.
Ho ho! Boobies.
Or not. It's like kind of. Kind of boobies.
No nipple boobies. Mm. I mean, there's still boobies.
Yeah, there's still boobies. So see that. So we're looking. We're fingering through here.
Yeah.
And it's a variety of different artists contributed to these issues, a variety of different art styles.
It's just so bad.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not bad, but it's bad.
It's just everybody's got their style.
I understand that. I'm not saying it's good though.
Of course, these are the cow freaking bugger. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, sure.
Everybody's got their different style. Everybody, look at that.
Yeah, that's Jason Statham.
That's pretty legit, right?
Jason Statham playing as Michelangelo.
Ah,
nice.
Good for
him. Yeah, because this is cool.
Okay.
I'm so glad you guys are just sitting there describing pages of a book that nobody can see.
Look at this. Look at the.
We're not even doing a good job of it.
No, look at this shot. So this is a shot of Alex is gonna love this. Look at that. That's Leo.
Yeah, look at that. Oh man, isn't that
great?
So
describe
what
you see here.
Fucking amazing. Jesus Christ. My God, it looks amazing.
It's so terrible.
Hey, let's keep talking about it.
Okay. Describe this. Yeah, describe what's happening here.
Oh, what
yeah.
I
let's
do?
Describe something that nobody can.
See what I did.
He's covered. Is that blood? I think it's blood.
Is it? No, it's not. It's clearly ketchup.
I don't even know what to say. It looks terrible.
It's this really weird version of Leonardo.
What are we still talking about? Tales of TMNT 8? Which one are we talking about now?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, that is correct.
And he is just covered in arrows and shurikens that are all just puncturing his body. His hands are covered in blood. And
a Foot Clan soldier is sparking up a blunt.
Oh, is that? I guess that is a. Oh, yeah. He's just rolled up his mask. Oh, yeah. Look at all the dead bodies behind him.
Nice.
Sure. It looks fantastic.
Oh, damn.
Please keep going. Please.
In the eye. All right.
No, seriously. Just please keep going.
Oh, that's.
I've lost robot. Interest in this. I'm done.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. That's like the T. Was it T-1000?
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, look, they're friends.
Look at that.
Holding hands. All right. Archie. This is an update on Archie. Archie update. We haven't had an Archie update in a while. TMNT Archie Adventures Volume 11, which collects issues 45 through 50 of the original Archie series, is out now. You can actually get it on Amazon. Volume 12, which collects issues 51 through 54, is coming September 13th. And I should note that the Archie Adventure series did go 72 issues. Plus, there were some, several different specials, like seasonal, the Mighty Mutanimal, Mighty Mutanimals.
Do you have, Ryan, the wrestling Archies? Do you have, like, that? Has that come out where they just released that entire arc?
I don't have all of them. The originals. The original. I haven't gotten any of these re-releases, but of my originals that I have, I do not have all of the intergalactic wrestling ones.
Yeah,
look into that. Is there a comic shop around here?
Yeah,
We should actually go. We should do. We'll go after the show. All right.
That'll be fun.
Darby, you should you should come.
I probably should.
All right. So, let's go into movie news. Okay, I know you guys don't like that. You guys don't like, you've said it multiple times. You don't like that intro, right?
No, it's stupid. It's literally just that. It's like, come on, man. We can't think of, there's no good movie clips we can come up with.
So you got one?
I'm sure I could find one in less than a minute. That's better.
Hold on. I'll find one in a second.
I could just do.
April O'Neil, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
No, that's just, isn't that just news?
Yes. I didn't play it this one, but yeah. So, anyway. June 3rd.
Go ahead. We don't need ya.
There you go. That's the move. Or you can do pork rind. Oh, those clips are infinitely better.
You like the pork rind?
Like,
done.
Or you could do Raphael just screaming damn at the top of his lungs. All better clips than what you keep playing.
All right. Oh, let's see. Oh, we don't have it. Oh, there it is. We need the audio. There we go. Oh, yeah, the time scepter.
Sorry.
You get the time scepter is out. And April is dressed up like a some sort of...
Done.
Why?
Done.
What? Elvis Presley, Love Hawaii.
Done.
Oh, that's so bad. June 3rd is coming soon. Of course, the release of Out of the Shadows. And it's rated PG-13.
You know what would be a good one?
What?
When Shredder's talking to the foot in the first movie.
First movie.
And he's giving that speech.
Yes.
To the foot.
That's way too long of a clip, though.
Well, I mean, God, you just want
that's
everything.
So long. I just don't want a minute and a half long freaking clip.
You know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
You could do a Megan Fox clip. No?
We could do a Whoopi Goldberg clip. We could do a Orange Crush
clip. Time to get into movie news.
very nice.
we may have a good clip from the new movie.
See, already better.
That's
than
true. No,
the
again, no.
Is.
Alex made a very good point. We might have a really good clip coming out of this movie.
Good.
I did think about, you know what I did think about? I did think about the beatboxing.
Oh, yeah.
The beatboxing was a good clip in the 2014 movie.
Oh yeah, hey, I'd be down for that.
But let's see. Let's do that when we watch the movie. Let's keep that in mind. If there's any clips that we want to make as our new intro for the movie section, it would be nice to incorporate the new movies into this because that's all we really talk about. All right, so several new trailers out right now. You can go to youtube.com/TMNTMovie1. The number one, because somebody else already owns youtube.com/TMNTMovie. That's funny.
They're probably hoping to get a nice payday for that one.
So, yeah. Oh, I'm sure. They apparently forgot that somebody could just get TMNT Movie 1 instead. So anyway, several new movie trailers are out. They're just coming out like... God, there's like two or three like every day now. We've got clips of Casey. I've got like talking under his helmet. It's pretty cool. There's a brand new one that just came out. We got our first real good look at Krang outside of the android body.
It's Krang.
Not gonna lie.
It's a Krang.
Pretty freaking good.
Yeah.
It's Krang man.
So Krang's he's got a little chin candy hanging
it's
down.
It's Cthulhu.
Which.
Cthulhu?
It's Cthulhu.
He's got the Cthulhu thing going on. All hail the mighty Cthulhu.
So
great
what,
and powerful Dark Lord Cthulhu.
Now, what happened here? Because it looks like he's hanging on. So, again, show notes for this. But what happened here with his head? I think he's on the android body, but there's no head left or something. I don't know. Something happened here.
He's shooting a unibeam from his chest, a la Iron Man, really.
Yes. Yeah, very true. Again, shout out to TigerClaw305 for sending us this screen grab.
It's the spark.
Ah. Oh.
Y'all spark.
Y'all spark.
Michael Bay.
Want to play this. This is some audio from the... this is director Dave Green and producer Brad Fuller discussing Out of the Shadows. And the interviewer is kind of... Not super excited about this, but want to play the audio of this right quick for everybody. And of course, there's a commercial. You got to be kidding me. And I'm not going to play the whole thing because the whole thing is like 4-something minutes long. But I just want to skip ahead to one of the portions here that I think is probably the most significant part of what he's discussing here. So. Let's see here.
I'm trying to make up. But talk a little bit about introducing that to the world and these new characters that a lot of fans have wanted to see.
Okay. So we, you know this, we listen to our fans, and they love to write to us and tweet us, and they reach us any way they can. And after the first movie, we heard a lot of things that people were looking for. They wanted Krang. They wanted the Technodrome. They wanted Casey Jones, Baxter Stockman, and so in the interim from the first movie to when we started this one, we really paid attention to what the fans wanted, and we tried to give them some of those things. And so we've introduced a number of new villains in this movie, but Shredder is still there. We spend more time with the Turtles, getting to know them as a brotherhood. I mean, last time, as Dave said, it was about learning who they are. This time you really get to see them in the present, interacting with one another. They each have very distinct personalities that in this movie you will get a total handle on who is and what they want to accomplish. And at the end of the day, I think that we were able to up the ante on the action and deliver the immense set pieces. I mean, as big as I've ever done. And we're very proud of all of those things.
That's actually.
So then the interviewer goes on to ask him about the Terrordrome. Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Yeah. Play it. That's fine.
They correct them. Tell me they corrected them.
Talk a little bit about introducing. I mean, in the trailer, I believe there might be a hint of the Terrordome, and I believe at like one of the Comic Cons I was with, WonderCon, there was like toys of the Terrordome.
So Technodrome.
What am I saying?
It's okay. Yeah, it's okay.
I'm clearly not a fan.
Wow! The balls on this guy.
Oh, that's fantastic. So,
like, anyway. I almost respect it.
He was owning it.
I almost respect it. Yeah, because he just straight up was like, well, clearly I'm not a fan. And it's like, wow. Like and the guys they were interviewing should have straight up been like, okay, we're done. Or something, I guess. But that was hilarious.
You say, no, there is no Terrordome in this movie at all. Not at all.
I almost respect it. I'll leave it at that. I almost respect it.
We got the International Korean poster has been released. And it's funny because it's labeled the International poster, but it's the Korean poster, actually. That was pretty cool.
I'm a little bothered by the placement of the characters in that poster.
Hmm.
I want the Turtles front and center. I don't want Casey Jones in April. I'm sorry. That's me. That's my taste.
Yeah. We got some other posters here, which Darby, I do not have in the show notes. My bad.
So that means since I can't see it, and since the fans can't see it, you and Alex are going to talk about it for 30 minutes about what it looks like, right?
I mean, there's not much to talk about. It's just it's more individual posters, and then there's one with them all together in the water.
They've been all over. Everybody's seen these.
Yeah.
Things.
Right.
It's nothing new.
Cool. And then let's see. I want to mention a couple other things. There's a Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. Stephen and Amell introduces Casey Jones and talks Turtles. This is over on Collider.
Nope.
There's a interview.
Nope.
There's a interview with Brittany Ishibashi. where she is going to be playing Karai. And I watched this whole thing. It's like a half hour long. I didn't listen. Right. I didn't watch it. I listened to it. But it's actually pretty interesting. She's a full on black belt. I think in Taekwondo. And so having somebody who's not only an actress but also a well trained martial artist playing the role of Karai, that is encouraging to me. So, I'm feeling good about Karai in this film, way more than in the last one.
I'm feeling better about this film mostly just because they straight up said, "Hey, so we're going 80s Turtles in this one," and yeah. It's like I can accept that.
Well,
then.
I mean,
I can accept Raphael hitting a plane head on and being perfectly fine.
Yeah,
like when I first saw that, I was like, "Wow!" I even sent you guys a message. Hey guys, just got this trailer in, and well, here's the information. Do with it what you will. But yep.
He is bulletproof.
And then when they said, "Hey, we're going 80s Turtles with it," I was like, "Okay, I can forgive it."
Yeah.
Better.
I mean, yeah, you just heard them. I mean, they're listening to the fans, so that's huge. I think when any creator of a creating something that's already within a well-established franchise, if they do not take into account what the fans of that franchise want, they're just doomed for failure. So. It is important to see that they are now listening and that they are taking all of that into consideration when making this film. Last thing I wanted to mention here is Out of the Shadows set visit report over on Den of Geek. So we got a link to that in the show notes as well. Tiger Claw, once again, helps us out. Let us know that Steve Jablonski is...
Who is just Michael Bay's go-to guy for scoring his movies.
Oh, is that right? Okay.
Oh, my God, dude. This guy, like... All right, I'll just read... I'll go real quick down this list, but, Bad Boys 2, The Island, Transformers, Transformers Revenge of the Fallen, Transformers Dark of the Moon, Transformers Extinction, Pain and Gain, like... And Transformers 5. He apparently is doing Transformers 5. So yeah, he's kind of Michael Bay's go-to guy.
Did you you knew all that off the top of your head?
Oh God, no! I looked it up on Wikipedia when I knew we were going to talk about this guy next. Okay. I just wanted to see what else he's done.
So
because I didn't know much about him, so I wanted to see what else he's done. I just went down the list. He's done a lot more stuff, obviously. But oh yeah, he also did Pearl Harbor, another Michael Bay movie. That's the thing, though. He just seems to be Michael Bay's go-to guy.
Interesting. So yeah, so we got a photo of it as well. Of
he also did Battleship.
Battleship. That's the one with Rihanna, right? I think it was.
Sure.
I think it was one with Rihanna.
Sure.
I hope you're not right. For your sake.
Oh, he's right. No, he's actually right. That's why I said sure. He's actually right.
Work.
Yep. Hey, maybe he wrote that for her too, since she doesn't write her own music.
Yeah. A lot Shots of fired. Producers.
All right.
All right. So we're going into mutated messages.
My favorite part of the show.
Yes. Please, a moment to reflect.
So, Sonia Preston said, "Hey guys, I thought you'd like to see this TMNT art video." So we're gonna pull it up because Alex has seen it several times already, right?
Just a few.
Yep,
just a few.
So this is actually pretty cool. I checked this out when it was sent.
Oh yeah.
This is pretty cool.
Are you guys watching the porn parody over there? What was that audio?
So this is the TMNT art video that was sent, and so check this out. We got a link in the show notes as always, but it's this really cool way that it's through this layering of paint.
Oh, it's spray paint. It's spray paint art. You see this everywhere. I actually.
Oh yeah, I saw this
years ago.
A guy
when I
was
went to Mexico. I actually got one of these, not this exact Turtles one, but I got. Some spray paint art when I went down there years ago. It's very impressive how they do this.
So how is Mexico everywhere?
No, I said you see the spray paint art everywhere, including like places like Mexico. Or there's a lot of artists that do
the Mexico.
This. It's great. I love it.
That's true. The other day, when I was at work, a guy was taking a shit, and he was actually doing this in the stall. So it was,
yeah, believe it.
Just everywhere.
It's that easy. It's not easy at all. I'm very impressed with this video.
It is very cool. So definitely suggest you take a look at that short video. DPC.
I wonder if she has a print of that or something for sale. Or oh God, I would buy that.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
That's a great piece of art.
DPC.
See that? I'm not going to spend $2,300 on, but I'd rather have that.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic looking. I agree. DPC hit us up and said episode 3 of his podcast is up, and I just want to say thanks to Yakko Pinky and us for inspiring him. And thank you, DPC, for always being a longtime listener and in front of the show.
And you're welcome.
Jared Wilson, the Jared Wilson on Twitter. This is legit.
Yeah, I love it.
He just got the original Michelangelo tattooed on his arm, and it's awesome.
Did Kevin, I mean, he tweeted it at Kevin. Did Kevin ever respond to it?
I don't know. I'm not sure. But yeah, that's fantastic. That's major props.
I'm a fan. That takes a lot, man, to just like permanently tattoo yourself with a character like that. It's great though. I mean, if you're gonna get a TMNT, you see a lot of TMNT tattoos, but I haven't really seen 87. That one. Many.
A lot of 87 turtles.
Yeah, a lot of comic ones too, or like in the style. But I actually haven't seen the original Mikey tattoo. I like it. The guy who did it did a pretty good job. Of course,
yeah,
saw you really
did a very good job. Yeah, very true. Travis Tackett on YouTube said, love your podcast and would love to play as Mikey with y'all. I believe he's referencing the game. So.
Nice.
So yeah. Nice. Check Twitter and Facebook for those announcements when we'll be playing. CK Gilmore says, the movie is shaping up to be great. Fingers crossed they deliver on the humor and faith they're hinting at. So yeah, fingers crossed here as well. I think we're all assuming this is going to be... I hope we're not setting the bar too high. I mean...
Oh, no. I've kept the bar so low after the last movie. Oh, well.
What are we talking about?
I just...
This movie. Huh? Fingers crossed on this movie?
I'm on Twitter.
Fingers crossed on this movie?
Oh, no. I know. It's gonna be great.
Yeah.
It's going to be great.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's going to be good. Vegan Sarney says, started watching season 7 Back to the Sewers the other day. That was the 2K3 series. The turtles have proper eyes instead of the white ones.
Which is why I don't like them.
I'm so pleased. My favorite.
Apparently, Vegan Sarney and I disagree on that, but
yeah, that's okay.
Fair enough. No, I get it. I get why people would like it. It's just, man, I preferred the no pupils for the 2K3 ones.
It says our favorite episode so far is from the season 7 is episode 9, Super Quest, which is the MMORPG episode. So funny. Oh. Have you guys seen it? I don't recall it one off the top of my head, but now that you've mentioned it, I will need to go back and check that out. I have them all, and I brought them all with me to Denmark last time I went, but I didn't get all the way to season 7. So I'll check this one out. And then have you seen this hashtag Shell and Tell thing on Twitter?
No, but I'm curious.
I have seen it. I think the movie is the one that's promoting it, but it's basically trying to get Turtles fans to photograph their collection and tweet it out with the hashtag Shell and Tell.
This guy's got the poster for the first movie.
This is still Vegan Sarney.
Respect on that one. Yeah, good for Vegan, man. It's just like I'm impressed with that. That poster, awesome. I probably would have framed that. I think Ryan, you had that framed like growing up back in the day, didn't you?
Yeah, this one is. Well, this is the. So, actually, if you zoom in, that is actually the High Tech 3 and Yakid K spin that wheel.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Check that out. So, with the background of the original poster, yeah. So, that's even more, like, rare. That's super rare right there. And then Tim G, TimG311, of course, longtime listener. Says, really liked the trailer. Wasn't expecting them to do a retro mutagen subplot for the Turtles, but I think it can work.
See, when I saw that, that's when I was like, okay, I'm actually invested in this movie now because I much prefer them having I'm not going to say a serious storyline, but something compelling of like, look, this can actually cause strife between the turtles, because obviously, you know, Raph might want to turn human and Leo's going to be like, no, that's stupid. And to me, that's great. I actually like that subplot idea. Yeah. I agree, Tim G.
Well, I mean, you know, Turtles, can we call it Turtles 2? The original Turtles 2? So confusing.
Yeah.
Secret of the Ooze. There was the whole reverse mutagen subplot in that as well. So, so I guess it's kind of.
But that was different. That was a retro mutagen to turn Toka and Rezar back to what they were.
Well, sure. Jacob Harmon says, played some Vanilla Ice on the jukebox. Half the bar was singing Ninja Rap. It was amazing.
I believe it.
It's always good to see. That's such a catchy song.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Bert the Stormtrooper says he's got his, you know, he does the toy reviews and always lets us know about them. So he's got two new.
He's a huge Ghostbusters guy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That dude loves Ghostbusters.
He's got two new reviews for all of the Out of the Shadows toy line. So we got links to that in the show notes.
I wonder what he thinks of the new movie trailer.
Hmm.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. And
me and him are connected on Facebook. I've seen a lot of his stuff. It's good. The guy's got, I mean, he posted a picture a couple of days ago. He just had a huge wall of toys behind him, just like, yeah, I'm just gonna review these. And I was just like, impressive, sir, well done.
Yeah, I remember when he just was basically kind of getting that started. So
Leonardo's animatronic head.
Yeah, so he's got it going here. All right, so what you just heard there is the next story. So David McDonald sent us a link. This is pretty cool. This is a DIY TMNT animatronic head that this artist who goes by Old Trenchy, as you can tell, I don't know. Was that British?
Or it looks like the one from the parody movie.
But this is audio animatronics, right?
But it's a DIY. Like, he built it himself, right?
Yeah. So he's doing a full costume.
Super impressive.
Yeah, very, very impressive. And the fact that it's not just like a Dead Eyes one. Like,
oh, the eyes blink.
Yeah, the eyes blink and everything. Like, especially when he kind of tilts his head down like that and you can't see. Like, that's weird. That's like
the brow movement.
Yeah, it's really good. Yeah, because you can't see his neck.
I know, you don't do anything like this. You're only an engineer. What the hell?
Because I'm only...
He does nothing. He does nothing with his degree. Nothing.
And the mouth moves too. Jesus.
Because I'm busy working on my PhD. That's why. Someday I would love to do this kind of stuff. Let's see. I think that's actually going to do it. So, do we have
any... Wait, hold on.
Oh. Darby has things he wants to talk about.
I have a question.
Darby has a question.
I have a question Darby for you guys. We didn't talk about this before the show. So, Alex, you actually mentioned Majin Buu earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
So you guys know DBZ. So I pose a question for you guys. Our buddy Sal, another big, big friend of the show. I follow him on Facebook too. Yep. He actually drew a picture of, he's a big Vegeta guy. And he's also a Donnie guy. So he drew a picture of Vegeta with Donatello. Fine. I get it. He's a fan of both. It's his art. I understand it. I appreciate it. But wouldn't really compare Vegeta to Donatello. More of a Raph thing, right? So I guess my question to you guys is, like, for that, for, you know, if you were going to have, like, a turtle team up with a member of DBZ, like, which one do you think your turtle would team up with?
Leo would be Goku. Right?
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course.
Vegeta, okay, Raph.
Yep.
I guess... Piccolo and Donatello?
No, I disagree.
No? Who do you see,
Donnie? Ryan, you're not getting in on this?
Dragon Ball Z.
Oh, that's funny. All right, so I guess Alex and I will just talk about this.
So that guy wears purple, so he's Donatello.
Hang on, let's do this.
And this guy's green.
He's not Donatello. He's not Donatello. Just because he's green and he wears purple, he's not Donatello. I think Donatello...
Oh,
honestly,
he also wears purple.
I would put him with Gohan.
They're all Donatello, because they all wear purple. All right. Except for that guy. He's got orange on, so he's obviously Michelangelo.
What's up?
I think...
That guy's got a red belt and green... That guy's Raph.
Stop. So...
Wait, who's he pointing at?
He was pointing at Tenshin.
Tenshin? I thought it was Tenshin too. Yamcha is Mikey. Is that it? No. Here's the thing. I would put Donatello with Gohan because Gohan, though not the strongest, he tends to step up when he has to.
Yeah.
I mean, he only defeated Cell. Granted, Goku helped him, and so did Vegeta. But he defeated Cell, and he held off Boo for as long as he could when he went Mystic. Cool. He's not the strongest, but he steps up when he has to. So I actually would have put Gohan with Donnie.
So,
and then I guess, and then for Michelangelo, Goten, because he's so young and chipper and happy and the world is great.
Sure.
Until he has to fight Majin Buu.
Yeah.
I mean, Alex, you're the only other DBZ fan here, apparently, so you tell me, man. I'm trying to engage.
I mean, I was thinking Raph.
I'm also trying to engage our fans. If our fans want to send us a tweet on who they think, I'm down with that as well.
I could see Raph as Vegeta or as Trunks. Either or, I think, is acceptable.
Well, probably Vegeta Trunks. More so. Future Trunks. You can't just say Trunks. It's
okay. Future Trunks. What about
that guy's Krang.
Oolong is Krang.
Oolong is Krang.
That guy's that guy's Shredder. That guy's Shredder right there.
Nappa? No. Nappa's not.
He looks like Shredder.
No. Nappa's not Shredder.
Who's Shredder?
Nappa's not even. No.
Who's Shredder?
Who's Shredder?
Well, that guy's got a lot of spikes.
I didn't even think of that.
Might be Shredder. Go back.
Yeah.
Go back.
Via Frieza.
That guy right there. Raul, the next one.
Raditz?
Frieza. Yeah. I could see Frieza.
Yeah. That guy. Look at all the spikes he's got. Is that his hair?
Yeah. Raditz. Raditz is not. No. No. I mean, no. No.
See, Frieza would be good for Shredder. They both have the same color combination, purple and silverish, and they're both dastardly evil. And,
or Captain Ginyu.
Ginyu.
It fits.
Oh, Ginyu. No, it doesn't fit.
Well, I mean, as far as the attire fits.
I would have gone with Frieza and Shredder. I'd like to see that crossover, actually. I think that could be pretty cool.
Go back. What do you want?
Yeah, there you go.
Master
I really just wanted to ask you guys, and I wanted to engage our fans to see if they would want to tweet us who they think.
The fifth turtle.
Team up with that.
Master Roshi is Splinter, I'm assuming.
Okay. He's so perverted, though.
Yeah, I know, but
such a dirty old man.
Wait, are you saying young Goten is
Mikey? Is
the fifth turtle?
That was the only thing I could think of.
That's Zach, the fifth turtle.
He's saying that Zach the Fifth?
Who's Zach the Fifth? Goten? Sure.
Son Goten. Or maybe... Oh, no. Maybe it's Pan.
Oh. And Bra could be Venus.
Mm.
Ooh. Or even better, we'll say Bulma. Bulma is Venus de Milo.
Ooh.
Or April O'Neil. April O'Neil. Bulma is April.
Yeah. That makes so much more sense. Instead of this fictional character you keep bringing up.
You guys, for the 2% of the crowd that knows what you guys are talking about, they are rolling on the floor.
Oh, that's more than 2%.
Yeah.
It's more than 2%. Hey, remember? Okay, so remember last episode when I was talking about how we had that thing where the Ninja Turtles were in that IGN tournament for teams?
Yeah.
Yeah, DBZ won the whole thing. They shouldn't have, but they did. So, Ryan, 2%? No, it's more than that.
Definitely shouldn't have.
But... Oh, no, they should not have taken out the Justice League. No. How was that?
That means it's time for a song of the show. This is going to be Rock the Plank, arranged by Steamage, featuring Viking Guitar.
Say Seaman?
Steamage.
Oh.
10-inch Mutant Ninja Turtles?
The source of this is going to be Skull and Crossbones.
Can we have the soundtrack? Can we have the soundtrack for 10-inch Mutant Ninja Turtles? Can that be the song of the show?
That could be. No, that's our movie. That's what we need. That's the clip we need for the movie.
Coming out of our shells. Oh. Spreader.
We got it.
Am I the only one a little disappointed that the spreader didn't do anything in that movie? Like at all?
No, I mentioned that earlier. I was kind of disappointed with that.
Yeah. I was like, man, Spreader, pretty hot. Maybe Spreader and you know, Raph.
April O'Neil.
Yeah. Oh. April O'Neil.
The source of this is Stage 6 background music from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 4, Turtles in Time, Skull and Crossbones. Wasn't it Shell and Crossbones? Anyway. Guys, we really would like, if you could really help us out here, we need some more iTunes reviews. We haven't gotten any in a while, and it really helps with getting the word out on iTunes. iTunes is really finicky with trying to find podcast stuff, so a lot of it is based on reviews, and otherwise I wouldn't even care. But if you look up Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles podcast on Google, we're number one, because I think Google does it right. If you look up Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles in podcasts on iTunes, we don't even show up. Like, we're like so far down the list, like you would never be able to find us. So if you go over to iTunes, just spend, you know, not even 5 minutes, just a minute or two, just to give us a rating, and you know, we'd really, really appreciate it. And we'll be sure to read those on the next episode. So for...
I'm just going to say we're number 1, 2, and 4. I'm pretty happy with that. I'm pretty proud of this. We got to pat ourselves on the back sometimes. Ryan's like, we're number 1. We're 1, 2, and 4.
Yeah. Well,
Suit Podcast, we're coming for you.
Want to say shout out to those guys. Yeah, definitely shout out to those guys. Yes. Oh, I should mention that as well before we sign off here. For any of the other Turtle Power we are the Turtle Power podcast. For any of the other Turtle podcasts that are listening out there, we will be
Did
in
you just
contact.
Say Turtle Power podcast again?
No, that was Turtle, a Turtle podcasts.
You could just say Ninja Turtle.
Podcasts. Yes, I could say Ninja Turtle.
I don't want a podcast that studies turtles to like come on.
There's a lot of them, so we should really distinguish which ones we're referring to. Yeah. Exactly. We are hoping to do a big, just like we did with the last one, with the last movie, a big spoiler cast after the movie releases. So for any of the other TMNT podcasts out there that would like to be involved, we're going to try to reach out to everybody. If you are interested and would like to be involved, hit us up, turtlepowerpodcast@gmail.com. You know the whole
or tweet us at TMNT
Podcast. That's easy too. Yeah. Facebook, yeah, any of those ways. We'll make sure that you get involved. Oh, and big news here, we are going to be coming soon, if not already, onto Google Play Music. So for all you Android kids, Darby,
all you people who have real cell phones
Are going to be able to find us on the Google Play Music store, because they just started a podcast section. So we should be on there. So, Darby, I'll put you in charge of checking on that.
What?
Thank you so much to everybody.
I don't get paid enough for this crap.
Oh, we've got some friends joining us.
Hello, there's. Hello.
Romeo and Juliet are here. So, Alex, it's been a pleasure. It's been fun. We got to do this more often. This is a lot of fun.
I haven't paid attention at all.
Well, I do get to rub you. That's fine. Your dog, I mean, when we're together. Darby, thank you.
Oh, yeah. Pleasure as always.
And we'll talk to you all next time.
Hey guys, make sure to check us out on our official website, www.turtlepowerpodcast.com.
Also, follow us on Twitter at TMNTpodcast.
You can follow me, Ryan, at FigDonPat.
Follow me, Alex, at ARodriguez2005.
Follow me, Darby, at DarbyTPatton.
Like us on Facebook, facebook.com/turtlepowerpodcast.
Make sure to subscribe on our YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/turtlepowerpodcast.
You can also share your feedback with us via old-fashioned email, turtlepowerpodcast@gmail.com.
Subscribe and rate us on iTunes.
And don't forget to subscribe and listen on Stitcher.